WainTech's built-in CodeSys supports the Profinet I/O controller. This video demonstrates how to configure it to communicate with a Siemens S7-1500 PLC. Open the Siemens TIA Portal project. Go to General, Ethernet Addresses, and set the IP address for the S7-1500 PLC. Enter the correct IP address based on your actual network environment. If your PC connects to the PLC through a router, check Use Router and enter the router's IP address. Next, go to Profinet, Profinet Device Name, and assign a unique name to the S7-1500 PLC on the Profinet network. If the name contains special characters, they will be automatically converted and displayed under Converted Name. Open Operating Mode and select I/O Device to set the S7-1500 PLC as a Profinet I/O device. Go to Transfer Areas and configure the data blocks accessible by the Profinet I/O controller. Change the data length to 2 bytes. Once the settings are complete, compile the project and download it to the S7-1500 PLC. After the download, go to Operating Mode, Export Generic Station Description File, GSD, and click Export. The GSD file will be used later in the CodeSys project. Open the CodeSys project and go to Tools, Device Repository, to install the GSD file of the S7-1500 PLC. Add Ethernet, Profinet I/O controller, and Profinet I/O device to the project. Then, go to Device, PLC Settings, Always Update Variables, and set it to Enabled 2. In Ethernet General Interface, select ETH0. Next, open PN Controller General and set the IP address range for Profinet I/O devices. Devices outside this range won't be able to communicate. In PN Controller Topology, choose the communication port. Go to Profinet I/O Device, General, and set the IP address to match the S7-1500 PLC. Ensure the PN controller has a unique station name on the Profinet network. Set the reduction ratio. For the first test, it's recommended to use the maximum value. When finished, download the project to the CodeSys PLC. Write values to QB0 and QB1 in CodeSys. If the values appear in IB0 and IB1 of the Siemens PLC, the communication is working. Similarly, write values to QB0 and QB1 in the Siemens PLC. If the values appear in IB0 and IB1 of CodeSys, the communication is confirmed. Thank you for watching.